And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Steve Ross.
I was trying to find out the right words to describe this lovely, expansive, sweet soul that we are here to honor. But as usual, Mr. Cole Porter, our favorite Episcopalian composer, has come up with something that just fits the spot. She has a beau. His name is Jim. He loves her and she loves him. But when he tells her she's too prim, that means she's too slow. She lets him rant, she lets him rave, she lets him muster a permanent wave. But when he says, let's misbehave, her reply is, no. It's not 'cause she shouldn't, not 'cause she wouldn't. Lord knows, it's not 'cause she couldn't. It's simply because she's the laziest gal in town. Her poor heart is aching to bring home the bacon, but she's alone and forsaken. It's simply because she's the laziest gal in town. She's more than willing to learn how those girls get money to burn. Every proposition she turns down, way down. It's not 'cause she shouldn't, not 'cause she wouldn't. And Lord knows it's not 'cause she couldn't. It's simply because she's the laziest gal in town. Though she's more than willing to learn how those girls get money to burn, every proposition she turns down, way down. It's not 'cause she shouldn't, not 'cause she wouldn't. Lord knows it's not 'cause she couldn't. It's simply because she's the laziest gal in town. She would, she should, she won't, because she is the laziest, the laziest gal in town. As Pearl Bailey might have said, honey, I'm just tired. And here is the laziest gal in town herself, Meryl. Now, I actually, because I know this is a new part of your life, you want to assemble yourself with your music and a microphone nearby. Yes. And a lot of us in the audience really have... Get yourself a mic.
Oh, the mic.
The mic over there. Ethel Merman, you're not.
My. Oh, can I take this one?
Take that one.
It's so nice looking.
It matches the outfit.
So whatever.
Okay. Lot of us are realizing this is a new thing. This is a new chapter in your life. Many of us have been through it. Yes. Many of us have to look forward to it. So we thought, I got some questions from some of the audience members.
Nice. Yes, that's very nice.
And we're very curious to know the answers to these questions.
Oh, okay.
For example, who wants to be a millionaire?
I do.
Have flashy flunkies everywhere?
I do.
Who wants the bother of a country estate?
A country estate? I just cannot wait.
Who wants to wallow in champagne?
Ooh, I do.
Who wants a supersonic plane?
I do.
Who wants a marble swimming pool too?
I do.
And I do.
And all I want is you.
Now, who wants to be a millionaire?
Oh, I do.
Who wants uranium to spare?
I do.
Who wants to journey on a gigantic yacht?
A gigantic yacht. I like that a lot.
Who wants a fancy foreign car?
I do.
Who wants to tire of caviar?
I do.
Right. Who wants a private landing field too?
I do.
And I do.
And all I want is you.
Now, who wants to be a billionaire? You do, don't you?
I would take a millionaire.
Oh, okay. All right, millionaire.
I'd
go to every
I'd
swell affair.
Oh, I love swell affairs.
Who
I
wants
do,
to
I
ride behind
this,
a livery chauffeur?
A livery chauffeur.
They'll say, get her. Who wants an opera box, I'll bet?
Oh, I do. I love opera.
And sleep through Wagner at the Met.
Oh, I don't.
Maybe not. Who wants to corner Cartier's too?
I do.
And I do.
And all I want is you. The maestro Steve Ross. I am so lucky. I really, really am so lucky. And gosh, it is so good to see everybody. I love you all. I love you. 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 Oh my. Oh my. It's Todd, thanks for helping me. So what if I was the last person here, you know? I was surprised, but then I said to you, Todd, do you think anybody will be surprised and that I'm so late? And you said, no one. I'm old-fashioned. I love the moonlight. I love the old-fashioned things. The sound of rain upon my window pane. The starry nights that April brings. This year's fancies are passing fancies, but sighing sighs holding hands. This my heart understands. I'm old-fashioned, but I don't mind it. That's how I've got to be, as long as you'll agree to stay old-fashioned with me. Oh, good. Now, thank you, Steve. Thank you. Yeah, you know, I really am embarrassed, but I'm just shocked. I thought that I'd have everything together, but I really I love that song, and I love so many of the old standards. And I was thinking, that is because not many of you knew my father. Aunt Dosnes, my wonderful Aunt Dosnes is there, and the Shanes, and they did, and the Shermans and cousins. But Pelham, which was a sacred part of my life and part of our life, you never knew my father. You knew my mother. You knew Lydia, who was wonderful. But my father was a great romantic, and he loved the old standards, the American songbooks, songs, and I just loved hearing him sing them to my beautiful mother. And they both sang, and my brother and I witnessed a great, great love affair. This song that I'm singing is talks to me so much because it is what I really believe in. And I know all of you believe in that too, and I can just point to so many people who have been so great to me and who have made me very happy. Make someone happy. Just make one someone happy. And you will be happy to sing to, sing it with me. One smile that leaves you, one face that wakes when it's near you, one man you're everything to.
Fame,
if you win it, it comes and goes in a minute. But what's the real stuff in life to cling to? Love is the answer. Someone to love is the answer. Once you've found him, put your arms around him. Make someone happy. Just make one someone happy. Make someone like you've made me happy too. Make someone happy the way you've made me happy, and you will be happy too.
That's the way she feels about it.
You know, I was thinking that it is a myth. There's lots of myths in life, but you know, we have to be respectful. But you know, it's a myth that we think that that NYC, that New York is just for young people. And it isn't. And it is for everyone. And it's healthy and it's marvelous. And you don't have to be with someone. You can. And I'm happy to be back home. I really am. And Pelham and Great Neck were so wonderful. But I'm happy to be back home and with all my my showbiz buddies as well.
Not to mention your son.
Well, they're just about to be mentioned. My sons. You know what? Thank you. And I have a wonderful daughter-in-law, a beautiful daughter-in-law, and her name is Rachel. And she is, and I think of her, I think of you. I think of her as a daughter, and she is the mother of my two gorgeous, fabulous grandchildren. Ezra is 4, and Orly is 2. They couldn't be here tonight, and another time they'll be here, absolutely. But the people, all of you, have really made me so happy, and there is something in life about chapters, and everyone here means something to me. I know I'm very sentimental, but I really want you to hear that. And I am so honored that you've come. And thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. But there are two guys. There are two guys. Where's my other guy?
Not here.
Oh, God. Todd and Adam, you're back there. Great. Okay. So who really are the love of my lives, and I'm so proud of you, and you have made me happy every moment and in every chapter and always. And I'm so grateful and I'm so proud of Todd Stone, Adam Stone, Stone and Stone.
Hi. Hey guys, how are you doing?
Hey, is this for me? Hey everybody.
So I can use this.
Let's hear it.
Let's hear it.
For the wonderful
Meryl. For our mom. Our wonderful mom.
You are the best.
Do we not have the greatest mom in the world?
We are so lucky.
The most wonderful, most kind mom in the world?
We do.
I'm going to keep your hands moving. Who in here loves our mom? Clap. Woo! Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Who loves our mom? Yeah. Keep it going. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, no.
You guys are great. Anyway, I think that we have all been, so all of us here have been the recipients of our mom's tremendous love and her generous, giving, joyous spirit. And I think we're all lucky to be touched by her. I think it's a gift to be of her friend, her neighbor, her acquaintance, and let alone her son.
Yeah.
I feel immensely grateful for that. Now enough about her, okay? Mm-hmm. Now we're on the stage here.
Yeah,
Her progeny here,
yeah.
Right? I like that word. I don't use that much on
stage. Yeah, I don't know what it means.
That's great. That's okay.
That's great.
That's okay. Yeah. You know, we have strengths and weaknesses.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, so back to her, actually. So one thing that you guys, I think all of us should know about my mom, our mom,
mm-hmm.
I might say my because I wrote it that way, but
yeah.
It's our. You
it's
guys, you get
so
it, right?
Just so you know, it's there, our.
She had
yeah,
both of
our
us.
Mom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So anyway... One thing about our mom is she laughs when you're speaking, that doesn't mean you're funny necessarily, because she laughs at everything.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. We kind of had to learn that the hard way by becoming comedians.
Yeah.
And it turns out like our biggest gig of the week is Meryl's Medicare Musical.
Yes, this is it.
That's where we
this
are.
This is it.
Meryl at the Medicare Musical.
Yeah, but look at this
but
though.
I'm
look
kidding.
At this. This
I'm
is
kidding.
A packed
by the way, look at
theater.
This. This is the best gig probably of our careers.
Yeah, this
I
is.
Think. Yeah. So
this
thank
is.
You, Mom.
Thank
this
you.
Is really for us.
This is.
Thank
you,
you,
Mom, for
thank
getting
you.
An audience.
Yeah.
This is great.
Thank you. And which she does help us.
You
with,
do.
You know, thank you. Anyway, there was something else I wanted to mention about that.
Or do you want me to talk now?
Okay, you can talk.
But think about what you were going to
okay,
say.
Okay, I will. Thank
okay,
you.
Okay, well, I wanted to talk about...
Oh, yes, I
okay.
remember.
Okay,
I'm sorry
great.
To interrupt
okay.
you. I'm sorry to interrupt you. But anyway, so I think that last song was really apropos, Make Someone Happy.
It was.
I don't know about the lazy girl, but whatever, you tried, Steve. But anyway, so I think that did not hit the mark at all. But that's sweet. Anyway, particularly now, she's been anything but lazy. So thanks.
Yes.
But Steve, thank you
but
so
Steve,
much.
Thank you.
And by the way, Steve, you should know, is not only tremendously talented, but has a beautiful apartment. You should all of it, like, it's really stunning and really charming. He's very talented in multiple ways. It's fantastic. Anyway, sorry to digress. So back to my mom. So back to the laughing. So it's not insincere. She is genuinely laughing. And she's not putting you on or something. And that's because, well, A, she has, her standards are pretty low
mm-hmm.
to begin with. And B, I'm kidding for humor, and I don't
yeah.
even mean that. But more than that is that she genuinely just wants to make people happy. She really does. She laughs. She wants
that's
to make
true.
You feel good, happy, or you know, that you're attractive or intelligent or accomplished, whatever it is. She genuinely wants to make you happy. That's her goal, to make people happy. I know this sounds kind of weird, but our mother is actually a golden retriever.
Yes.
Yeah. That
yes.
She just dyes
that's,
her hair. She's
yeah,
been dyeing her hair
sweet.
For years.
That's
I kind of like
that's
that
true.
One.
That's, I like
you know,
that. And it's true.
No,
you
but
are.
You're just like a golden retriever, you know,
you
like
are.
Running around, licking a tail, wagging, whatever. Anyway, like all over the place.
Yeah.
Where am I going? What should I do? How can I make you happier? You have one.
Yeah.
Can I lick you? Can I touch you?
Yeah.
So anyway.
Can I get that for
can
you?
Can I get
yeah.
that for you?
And yeah.
I'm,
that's a good point.
So anyway, so that was my, that's what I wanted
very
to
nice.
Mention.
And
thank
I
you.
Have a story and you have
okay.
some, there's either
oh,
a dandruff
sorry. No,
or something.
No, it's dandruff. It's dandruff.
No, it's wet though.
I
have wet dandruff?
I always have dandruff.
Okay, anyway. So I want to share something. I was playing golf. At college, I was on the golf team, and thank you for laughing at that. And I was in my last potential. I yeah.
Okay.
My mom, that's very sweet. You're very nice.
Just because it's your birthday.
Hold on. She doesn't know that much about sports, and she just said that. With all sincerity, she just said I was president of the golf team, which is, thank you. That's very nice. Anyway, but she wasn't kidding. Anyway. It's captain, but I wasn't. But anyway, the point is, it doesn't matter. Okay, it's my turn. Anyway, So I was playing there, and it was really a big goal of mine to break 80. For those of you who know golf, I won't bore you too much, to shoot a 79 in a tournament. That would be a big thing for me. I had only done it once in my life, and I'm getting to the 17th hole. This is in a tournament. And the second to last hole, and someone else, I guess, was taking it very seriously. And I was on line to get to break a 79. And so it was very important. And another guy who I was playing with, he missed a putt. And I heard him mutter under his breath. He said, "I would have killed my mother for that." Okay, because he missed the putt. And then I thought about myself. And I thought, would I kill my mother to ensure that I shot a 79. And I thought about it, and it was a tough decision. But ultimately, I thought, no, I wouldn't. And that just shows how much
Mom,
I love you.
See, how much he loves you.
I wouldn't kill you for that.
That's a beautiful story.
But it was good
story.
Karma, yeah. And I wound up doing it anyway, which is good. Yeah. And I didn't have to kill you, and it was great. So that's my story.
Yeah.
Anyway, okay. We're going to talk a little bit. So Mom introduced us and my wife Rachel, and we lived.
She introduced the two of you?
No, she did not. No, she introduced us.
I didn't think that's what happened.
No. She introduced us to the stage and just talked about it. And I'm married to Rachel, and we have two kids. And so that's kind of about me.
Okay, so now
That was gonna be.
I thought you were gonna.
Yeah.
I get
yeah,
it.
Yeah, exactly.
No, you need to.
Why?
Oh.
Why do I need to?
Because it's funny.
Oh, no.
Okay, never mind.
Yeah.
Anyway, sorry about that. So I'm single, and a lot of people have been asking me if I have a type, which is nice. They're trying to set me up, and I appreciate that. But it occurred to me that I don't really have a type, because my last girlfriend was, like, pretty full-chested. And she happened to be Jewish, but that doesn't matter. Pretty full-chested. And, like, now I'm dating, like, a pretty flat-chested Italian guy, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
So, like, pretty
exactly.
different. So I have a broad
different.
Range.
Yes.
You know, so, like, I really don't have
yes.
a type.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
But, anyway, yeah. But seriously, I am gay, which is, like, a big deal, and it's kind of new it's, like, a new thing. I mean, not new for me, but new for my girlfriend, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
So it's a big deal.
Exactly.
So it is a big deal.
Yeah.
And so, anyway, so there was this guy. I was in an elevator, and this guy came into the elevator, and, like, I didn't know if he was gay or not or whatever. So he came in the elevator, and the doors close, and it's silent. And he breaks the silence by saying, "You smell." So I said, "Like what?" Mm-hmm. And he said, "Bad."
Yeah.
So, you know, at this point, I could tell he was flirting with me, you know?
Yeah,
like pretty hardcore. So I said, "Like good bad, like sexy bad, you know?" And then he took a little step away from me in the corner of the elevator, and I thought he was trying to play hard to get, you know? So I took a little step closer to him, and he pushed me. And I thought, I don't know, maybe this is like a sexual push. Like a gay push, I don't know. So, like, I pushed him back. And then he punched me in the face.
Yeah.
And we've actually been dating now for 4 months.
Yeah. That's great. Congratulations.
Yes, thank
That's
you.
That's great.
Thank you.
But it's been very weird for me, because now a lot of people are asking me if I'm gay, you know? And I find that a little strange, because I'm married to a woman, and I have children. And it's like, just because we're twins doesn't mean that, you know, I have to come out at the same time, you know?
Yeah.
Exactly. I'll do it. I'm just not ready yet, okay? Okay, I'll do it. Just give me some time.
Yeah.
And just don't tell anyone, and then I'll do it in a couple of years, okay? It's going to be tough on my wife, on my kids.
Yeah.
Anyway, I went to my doctor recently, and she said that my cholesterol was a little high. And I said, "Well, that's not good." And she said, "Yeah." She said, "You have to start running." And I said, "Well, I don't like running." I said, "What about walking?" And she said, "No." She said, "Walking's not going to work, because you need at least 20 minutes of a very elevated heart rate." So I said, "Okay, well, in that case, what if I just got really nervous? Would that work?" And she couldn't think of a reason why not. So nowadays, and I've told you, every other day, I go to my local Duane Reade, and I start shoplifting. And it's great. I just steal things for 20 minutes and I'm pouring sweat. Just pouring, and I just feel the carbs coming up, and
he
the calories
great.
Are burning.
He's lost
I feel
a lot of weight, actually.
So don't let anyone
so
tell you,
can,
you that you have to run.
Ways
okay,
to
there
lose
are
weight.
Ways to lose weight.
There, you know, you can do it multiple ways.
Thank
yeah.
you,
thank you, Adam.
Thank you.
So anyway, and we'll
thank
and we've
you.
Got a wonderful show for you.
Yes, we're just gonna we, do we're but, gonna but, do another hour straight,
yeah,
and then,
exactly.
then we're done.
And then the show.
And
will
then
come
we're
up.
Gonna bring up
By
other people.
By the way, these people are all so eager to get. Anyway, well, don't worry. We want you know, but it is anyway. So. So Adam saw a new doctor. I also saw a new doctor recently because I had a rash in my inner thigh. Well, since he's here, it was like, Adam,
yeah.
open
okay.
up.
Okay.
It was like right there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. And so, you know, and so I went to the doctor and I said, and he told me, he said, you have athlete's foot.
Yeah.
And but I was like, but there's nothing on my foot. It's here. And he said, no, it's athlete's foot. And then he proceeded to say, always put your socks on before your underwear. The socks go on before underwear. Put your socks before your underwear. And I had no idea what that meant or like how that was related.
Yeah.
Ultimately, he explained that otherwise, if you don't put your socks on first, your net, your foot can
it
graze
up against
your underwear
and
then bring
know,
the fungus
horrible.
In there. I know it's disgusting. So I'll tell you more.
Yeah.
If it's hot
yeah.
enough, if the temperature
the
is
temperature.
Right, it can actually cause a rash and
no,
be
yeah.
deadly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, no,
no, I'm kidding. No. I'm kidding. No, but whatever. So no, but so athletes no, so he said socks before underwear, and he kept saying that. Always put your socks on before your underwear. And he said that's actually one of the most important things I learned in medical school.
Yeah.
And I thought to myself, if that's one of the most important things that you learn in medical school, you should sue your medical school.
Yeah.
And I should stop finding my doctors on Craigslist.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And you did.
And I did.
And you did.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's good.
Yeah. Anyway. Finally,
oh,
one more. No,
just,
I think we should get
no,
the...
No, well, what were you going
to
say?
Okay, one last thing. Okay, sorry. I don't mean to dominate. I can do that. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
And so I was... I recently got... I was in the neighborhood, and I live here. I'm grateful to live here. I had got a new pair of sneakers. They were a little loud, kind of bright sneakers. And I saw this neighbor of mine, kind of middle-aged woman, and I told her... I said, oh, these sneakers, they're kind of loud. And she said to me... She said, no. She said, you do you. You do you. And, you know, what she meant was be yourself and, you know, don't apologize, which is great, and I appreciate that. And she said, you do you, she said. And I thought to myself, like, I don't have much sex at all. So, you know, it turns out that I do me virtually every night
yeah.
of the week.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm always doing me.
Yeah.
And I'm, like, really good at it, you know.
Yeah.
She said, and don't do your twin brother. And I, you know, and I don't do him either. I mean, we did once, but he didn't enjoy it.
No, that's how I knew
I
was straight.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I had a little fun, you know. So that's what, you know. Anyway, so I don't do him anymore. I briefly had a kind of boyfriend who, it turns out, like had an erectile dysfunction thing. So he said, you do you and I'll watch. You know, and so I did me and he watched. I'm always doing me.
Yeah.
If there was like a poster boy for doing you, it would be me.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then, you know, the poster that goes, you know, that old poster, we got a lot of old people, the World War I poster, a lot of you were around. I'm kidding.
No,
I'm kidding. By the way, I say this to all audiences. It's like a ha-ha, you know.
Yeah.
That's a joke. So, but you know the old poster with Uncle Sam? And he says, I want you. So I think my poster would be, so I'm doing me. Sorry if it's vulgar. I'm doing me in the left hand. And then in the right hand, I say, you do you. You know, you do you. The timing wasn't right. I'm
no,
sorry.
No, good. I like
but I
it.
Think
you
Steve
do
might have
you.
I think Steve didn't like it either.
That's
I'm so
okay.
sorry.
It's okay.
Okay, so that was supposed to be
yeah,
entertaining.
Exactly. That was
so
good.
So now
okay,
you're going
so
to go
what
off
do I
to
do?
The side.
I leave? Okay.
Sorry. Thank you. Okay. It's a grand night for singing. The moon is bright above, and somewhere a bird who is bound till be heard is throwing his heart at the sky. It's a grand night for singing. The stars are bright above. The earth is aglow, and to add to the show, I think I am falling in love. Falling, falling in love. Maybe it's more than the moon. Maybe it's more than the birds. Maybe it's more than the sight of the night and a light too lovely for words. Maybe it's more than the earth, shiny and silvery blue.
the reason I'm feeling this way has something to do with you. It's a grand night for singing. The moon is flying high, and somewhere a bird who is bound till be heard is throwing his heart at the sky. It's a grand night for singing. The stars are bright above. The earth is aglow, and to add to the show, I think I am falling in love. Falling, falling in love. Thank you, Steve. Thank you. Thank you. And now I have to introduce a very special someone. He needs no introduction. Come on, come on up.
Yes. Oh, no, please.
So I have never sung before. I know my mom sings and Todd sings, and I never really did that. But it's her 65th birthday, and you were talking about your parents, and they're wonderful people. And you know, somewhere in my mind, since I grew up in this world, these songs are there. They're just there, and occasionally I'll just start humming them or singing them. And again, I've never sung amateurly. I've never sung at all. But I just felt like today is the right time, and I just want to sing one of these standards, because there's beautiful songs there. They really are. But, you know, I'm going to do it my way. And it might sound a little different, and I don't know what to do with my hands, so I'm going to be juggling. And we'll just see what happens.
I'll start singing.
Okay. And then maybe start... Yeah.
Juggling.
Okay.
Some enchanted evening, you will see a stranger.
Bravo. Please welcome to the stage a young gentleman who is a great fan of Meryl, as we are. Please say hello to Gregory Gropper. Are you with us? There you come. Okay. Did I say the name wrong?
Comes you, it goes with your hair. You certainly know the right thing to wear. Moonlight becomes you. I'm thrilled at the sight, and I could get so romantic dressed up to go dreaming. Now, don't tell me I'm wrong. What a night to go dreaming. You mind if I tag along? If I say I love you, I want you to know it's not just because there's moonlight. Although moonlight becomes you so. Stand there just a moment. Won't you let me catch my breath? I've never seen a picture quite so lovely. How did you ever learn to look so lovely? You're all dressed up to go dreaming. Now, don't tell me I'm wrong. What a night to go dreaming. Do you mind if I tag along? If I say I love you, I want you to know it's not just because there's moonlight.
Gregory Gropper. Sharing the piano chores tonight is my great pal, Mr. Douglas Cohen, who is going to be accompanying Sandy Durrell.
Thanks.
Thank you, Steve Ross. You'll be seeing more of Steve later. I think tomorrow morning at 2 a.m. he'll come back. This is Sandy Durrell.
Hello, 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 hello. Hello, Medicare Merrill. So you named it, I didn't. So this is a song that I think is very appropriate under the circumstances.
The secret of life is enjoying the passage of time. Anyone can do it. There's nothing to it. Nobody knows how we got to the top of the hill. And since we're on our way down, we might as well enjoy the ride. The secret of love isn't opening up your heart. It's okay to feel afraid, but don't let that stand in your way. Everyone knows that love is the only road. And since we're only here for a while, might as well show some style. Give us a smile, isn't it a lovely ride? We go gliding down, don't try so hard, it's a lovely ride. The thing about time is that time isn't
really real. It's just your point of view. How does it feel for you? Einstein said we could never understand it all. The planets spinning in space, that smile upon your face. Welcome to the human race. Isn't it a lovely ride? I go gliding down. Don't try so hard. It's a lovely ride. Isn't it a lovely ride? We go sliding down, gliding down. Don't try so hard, 'cause it's a wonderful ride. Now the secret of life is enjoying the passage of time. Happy birthday, Meryl.
Sandy Durrell. Okay, so we also have Larry Weisfeld, who is here to entertain us with a standard with new lyrics. Yeah. Hey, Larry.
To the birthday girl. Beautiful within and beautiful without. Hungry till dinner's at 8. Loves cabaret, but sure to be late. She will bother with people she hates. That's why Meryl is a champ. She loves her apartment, it's comfy and small. For Adam and Todd, she's always on call. Through all her upheavals, she still has a ball. That's why Meryl is a champ. She loves her friends, parties, and streaks in her hair. Life without care. She's broke, is oak. Loves New York City, even cold and so damp. That's why Meryl is a champ. She works with Dutch, a smile on her face. Brushing here and there with incredible pace. She does Meryl's girls with style and with grace. That's why Meryl. That's why Meryl. That's why Meryl is a champ. Love you, Meryl.
Larry Weisfeld. The standard by Rogers and Weisfeld. And now, the singing experience of your life, Linda Emil Burns.
As a director, I can't stand that this mic is...
I know. Thank you for doing that.
Anybody needs the mic, they can bring it.
That's right. Yeah. Thank you.
So, Meryl, happy birthday. Meryl did take my workshop, The Singing Experience, and she sang a wonderful song by Rodgers and Hart. And, you know, she forgets the words sometimes. But instead of just stopping, she made up words that that Larry Hart would have been proud of. It was so fabulous.
And I go,
no, it was fab. It was so seamless. It was just great. So this is a tribute to our Meryl, one of the kindest, most loving people. Happy birthday, Meryl, this is your day. Meryl, it's so nice to celebrate you in this way. You're looking swell, Meryl, we can tell. Meryl, you are thriving, you are striving, you are on the way. We feel the triad is swaying, 'cause Doug Cohn is playing many of your old favorite songs from way back when. So never fear, Meryl, Medicare is finally here, Meryl, and you are only looking 43. You are now single and are free to mingle after many, many years of marital strife. You're on your own, Meryl, with a new life, Meryl, 'cause at 65 you're growing, you're still going strong. My, how you've grown, Meryl, the mother of stone and stone, Meryl, to funny guys who like to call you mom. So, wow, 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 Meryl, take a great big bow, Meryl, 'cause this really is your time to shine. Good birthday, Meryl, 65, Meryl, it's so nice that you are back where you belong. You're right on top, Meryl, never stop. Meryl, you're still singing, you're still swinging, you're still going strong. Here we are not lying, Meryl, the time is flying, Meryl, and your friends and family are so proud of you. Just never stop, Meryl, till you get to the top. Meryl, we are here to wish you the best, not to ever put you to the test. Meryl Stone, we wish you a happy day. Happy birthday, many, many more, to one of the nicest people ever.
Linda Emil Burns. Oh, Sydney's here. Oh, okay. We have a very special guest, so we're going to go a little bit out of order. I want to welcome to the stage Sydney, the one and only Sydney Myers. Hello, hello. Thank you.
Hello, good evening, everyone. I'm on my coffee break at work. I didn't mean to cut the line, but these things do happen. Well, I want to say we all adore you, and you and I have so much in common. We have food, cabaret, music, Medicare, and this. When most people end a love affair, they frequently go to pot or pills or gin or Haagen-Dazs and lie around a lot. But when this heart of mine's about to break, it's not uppers or downers or fudge caramel ripple I take. Between men, I take French conversation, how to roll sushi, or unroll a tent between men. I've learned reincarnation and sexual styles of the Orient. I've learned real estate, ballroom dance, scuba, ceramics, and Sten. When between men, between men, I have studied hypnosis and how to save someone who seems to be choking. And then I've learned self-diagnosis, and five times I've signed up for giving up smoking, and est, biofeedback, volleyball, yoga, and Zen. When Vuden between men. It's amazing how good I've gotten, how skillful, how sexy, how wise. Now when everything looks really rotten, how time flies between men. I took writing the novel, winning at blackjack, losing with grace between men. How to redo your hovel, how to raise sable, how to use mace. When I take up each hobby besides playing Barbie to Ken, I find a life of my own between men. I've learned takeoff and landing, maintaining Cadillacs, building a shelf between men. I've become so outstanding, I think I am falling in love with myself. So when things fall apart, well, me and my heart say amen. Between dates and divorces, I don't play the horses. I marshal my forces and sign up for courses. So the next guy who gets me is gonna get more than a 10. Now I'm torn between Ronnie and Roger and Johnny and Barry and Brian and Ben, which is clear to me. That's the best way to be. Oh, it's clear to see. That's the best way to be between men.
Sydney Myers.
Sydney came over today to rehearse. It was only like he was there for 10 minutes, but he brought lunch. You know, there's an entire song sung about ice cream, and he brings lunch. So that was a lovely thing, Sydney. Thank you. Now, moving right along, we have, I have to check our schedule. Yes, we have, you're going to be very entertained by Steve Weber.
Once I was a wallflower. There was no one forlorner. I went to every party, but I sat in the corner. And then one day, a magazine I read. It changed my life because, you know, way in the back where they had these ads that say, you can do this, you can be this, you can buy this. Here is what it said. You too can be the life of the party. You too can learn to play by ear. You too can toot on a cute little flute. Just join the Institute. You too can play a ragtime piano. You too can do a Fred Astaire. You too, my friend, can be clever. No end. And a dollar. Now, this was a while back. Here's all you'll spend. Your friends may laugh, yes, because friends are funny that way. But their laughter will turn to amazement when you begin to play. Fall. Don't be a fool, you can do it if you'll join the chorus. Join the chorus. Join the correspondence school. Correspondence school. And let yourself go. Thank you. I have one more little phrase just for Meryl, and when I hear this phrase, it made me think of her. Walking down some strange new street, then you fly down the street on the chance that you'll meet. And you meet not really by chance. And we didn't meet by chance, so pleasure to meet you and know you. Thank you.
Todd was going to maybe do this, but he then had to step out to deal with some thing in the back. And you don't want to hear me sing again. So I will introduce our next act. I wish I had telepathy with my brother. I don't. So I don't have the introduction. But if you wait there for 20 minutes, I will know something soon. But Todd is dealing with a surprise in the back, and he will do that. Todd, I think you need to be coming, or I'll just talk. Throw out a standard, I'll sing it. Never mind. Okay. The Janes, here's Todd. And I see him. Here he comes. Here. Okay. Todd is back. He just dealt with someone back. There was some pretty serious business going on in the back. I had to handle. Sorry, everyone. We're all safe. We're all safe. It's going to be okay. I just had to handle that. Okay, so the next act, they're pretty incredible. One of them is one of our greatest audience members. I love her. She's beautiful and she's fantastic. And I came to see she and her two other fantastic singer friends. I saw them over here. I was sitting there and they were standing somewhere around here. I want to welcome. They're legendary. They've been performing for decades and they are so fantastic. Please welcome the Three Janes. Come on up. Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
And the last time we were here at the Triad, you were in the audience, and I said to you, I wish we could do an act together. And so now we are.
There you go.
Right? Okay.
Meryl.
This is for you.
Yeah.
This is for you.
And I've had those two drinks.
I have one saying. Big, strong one.
Yeah. We're going to have sandwiches soon. Mm. Yeah.
A one, two, three. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, 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 happy birthday. How old are you today? We're just asking. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday. How old are you today? No, don't tell us. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday. How old are you today?
Happy birthday,
we're just asking.
How old are you today? No, don't tell us.
Happy birthday,
happy birthday,
happy birthday.
How old are you today? We're just asking.
Happy birthday,
happy birthday.
My God, you look so young. It's the truth. My God, you don't look old. No, it's the truth. You look so young. Why, you might live forever and ever.
Why, you might live forever and ever.
Why, you,
why you might live forever and ever.
Why, you forever. Might live why, you might live forever and ever. Don't get stressed.
Forever and ever. Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Get lots of rest.
Forever and ever. Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Low fat food.
Forever and ever. Happy birthday, happy birthday.
And lots of sex.
Forever and ever. Happy birthday, happy birthday.
No red meat.
Forever and ever. Shall live forever and ever.
And you might
live forever and ever. Whole grain bread.
Forever and ever.
The doctor said.
Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Then you might live forever, forever and ever.
Don't get stressed.
get lots of rest, low-fat food, and lots of sex. Then you might live forever, forever and ever. You look young, forever and ever. Hallelujah, hallelujah, happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy
just for you.
So many years ago, when I was in school, I had to write a paper, and then I thought it would be fun, in addition to writing that paper, to do a medley of songs about women. And so this is what we would like to perform for you. It's Women in Transition, and we're going to perform it with our very own, very original 1991 soundtrack.
And we know that you have lived through this.
Yes.
So.
I can feel the 90s, can't you?
It cost me a lot, but there's one thing that I've got. It's my man. Cold and wet, tired you bet, but all that I can forget with my man. He's not much on looks and no hero out of books, is my man. Two or three girls has he that he likes as well as me, but I love him. He isn't true. Me too. What can I do? Sometimes it's hard to be a woman, giving all your love to just one man.
You know.
But if you love him, oh, be proud of him, 'cause after all, he's just a man. Stand by your man. Give him two arms to cling to and someone warm to come to when his nights are cold and lonely. Stand by your man. Just give him all the love you can. Stand by your man. I love him, I love him, I love him. And where he goes, I'll follow, I'll follow, I'll follow. He'll always be my true love, my true love, my true love. From now until forever, forever, forever. I will follow him wherever he may go. There isn't an ocean too deep, a mountain so high it can keep me away from my love. I love him, I love him, I love him. And where he goes, I'll follow, I'll follow, I'll follow. He'll always be my true love, my true love, my true love. From now until forever, 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 I will follow him. After a while, I'm myself again. I pick the pieces off the floor, put my heart on the shelf again. He'll never hurt me anymore.
No, not him.
I
tell myself, don't be a chump.
You chump.
Who cares? Let him stay away. That's when the phone rings and I jump. And as I grab the phone, I pray, let it please be him. Oh, dear God, it must be him. It must be him, or I shall die. Or I shall die. Oh, hello, hello. Oh, dear God, it must be him.
But it's not him.
And then I die.
Cha-cha-cha.
Some boys kiss me, some boys hug me. I think they're okay. If they don't give me proper credit, I just walk away. They can beg and they can plead, but they can't see the light.
That's right.
'Cause a boy with cold hard cash is always Mr. Right. 'Cause we are living in a material world, and I am a material girl.
You know that
we are living in a material world, and I am a material girl.
Stop right there. I gotta know right now. Before we go any further, do you love me? Will you love me forever? Do you need me? Will you never leave me? Will you make me so happy for the rest of my life? Will you take me away? Will you make me your wife? Do you love me? Will you love me forever? Do you need me? Will you never leave me? Will you make me so happy for the rest of my life? Will you take me away? Will you make me your wife? I gotta know right now. Before we go any further, do you love me? Will you love me forever?
And then he says, let me sleep on it. Baby, baby, let me sleep on it. Let me sleep on it. I'll give you an answer in the morning. Let me sleep on it. Baby, baby, let me sleep on it.
No.
Let me sleep on it. I'll give you an answer in the morning.
I gotta know right now. Do you love me? Will you love me forever? Do you need me? Will you never leave me? Will you make me so happy for the rest of my life? Will you take me away? Will you make me your wife? I gotta know right now. Before we go any further, do you love me? Will you love me forever?
Go into the chapel and we're gonna get married. Go into the chapel and we're gonna get married. Gee, I really love you and we're gonna get married. Go into the chapel of love. Chapel of love. Yeah, 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 yeah. Go into the chapel of love. Here comes the bride.
his baby. What a lovely way of saying how much I love him. Having his baby. What a lovely way of saying what I'm thinking of him. I can feel it. My face is glowing.
I can see it in my eyes. And I'm happy in knowing
that we're having his baby. I'm a woman in love and I love what it's doing to me. Having his baby. I'm a woman in love and I love what it's going through me. Having his baby.
What's coming?
You keep playing where you shouldn't be playing. You keep thinking that you'll never get burned.
Ha!
I just found me a brand new box of matches. Yeah. And what I know you ain't had time to learn. These boots are made for walking. And that's just what I'll do. And one of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you.
You've been lying when you ought to be a-truthin'. You've been losing when you ought to not bet. You've been shaming when you ought to be a changing. You know, what's right is right, but you ain't been right yet.
These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. And one of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you.
Well, I'm gonna tell you something.
You don't own me. I'm not just one of your little toys. You don't own me. Don't say I can't go with other boys.
And don't tell me what to do. And don't tell me what to say. And when I go out with you, don't put me on display. 'Cause
you don't own me. Don't try to change me in any way. You don't own me. Don't tie me down, oh, 'cause I'll never stay.
I'm young and I love to be young. I'm free and I love to be free. To live my life the way that I want. To say and do whatever I please. 'Cause you don't own me.
Wash out 44 pairs of socks and have them hanging out on the line. Starch and iron 2 dozen dress shirts, for you can count from 1 to 9. Scoop out a big dipper full of lard from the drippings can. Throw it in the skillet, go out and do my shopping, and be back for it melts in the pan.
'Cause I'm a woman, W-O-M-A-N. I'll say it again. 'Cause I'm a woman, W-O-M-A-N.
Tell him, Sula.
I can rub and scrub this old place till it's shining like a dime. feed the baby, grease the car, and powder my face at the same time. Work a full-time job, go out and swing all night and then go to bed at 5, jump up at 6, and start all over again. 'Cause I'm a woman, W-O-M-A-N. I'll say it again. 'Cause I'm a woman, W-O-M-A-N. Come on, Chris, tell us. I can stretch a greenback dollar bill from here to kingdom come. I can play the numbers, pay my bills, and still end up with some. I got a $20 gold piece, says there ain't nothing I can't do. I can make a dress out of a feed bag, make a man out of you. 'Cause I'm a woman, W-O-M-A-N. I'll say it again. 'Cause I'm a woman, W-O-M-A-N.
Meryl.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Yay! Naciste, nacieron todas las flores. En la pila del bautismo cantaron los ruiseñores. Ya viene amaneciendo y a la luz del día no dio. Levántate de mañana, mira que ya amaneció. Quisiera ser solecito para entrar por tu ventana darte los buenos días acostadita en tu cama. Con cadmines y flores este día voy a adornar. Hoy por ser día de su santo le venimos a Happy birthday to you, happy birthday.
saliendo de contrabando. En la Sierra Morena, cielito lindo, viene embarcando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo, de contrabando. Cielito lindo que a mí me toca. Y a las morenas quiero, cielito lindo, desde que supe que morena es la Virgen, cielito lindo de Guadalupe.
Thank you very much.
Muchas gracias, muchas gracias. That is what is known as a very hard act to follow. But the gentleman whom you are now going to hear has truly one of the most magnificent voices ever to have been heard on Broadway and many, many other places. My good friend, Mr. Walter Willison.
Wanted to say, this is, oh, thank you. This is like a first. Thank you, my dear. You know, this is like a first because it's the first time I've ever followed a mariachi band. I swear it's true. I swear. I know they were, but you know, hell. I wanted an opening act, so they were back there. I said, go on now, guys. So here's the deal. So when Meryl called me, she emailed me actually, and she said, would you sing that song, La Da 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 Da? I swear to you. You did, right? Of course, I knew exactly what she meant. I did. And although Marty Charnin would be very upset to that. Yeah, it's a song actually from a show that I did called 2x2. Thank you. And it was, that was a long time ago. It was written especially for me by Martin Charnin and Richard Rodgers. Yeah, I think, right? So tonight, I'm doing it especially for you. I do not know a day I did not love you. I can't remember love not being there. The planting when the earth ran through your fingers. The harvest when the sun danced in your hair. I do not know a day I did not need you for sharing every moment that I spent. I needed you before I ever knew you, before I knew is full and filled with song. You will not know a day I do not love you the way that I have loved you. As we face the promise of tomorrow, one fact alone is full and filled with song. You will not know a day I do not love you the way that
Waldo Wilson. Okay. Bring back, please, Mr. Doug Cohen.
That was beautiful. I've never followed someone who followed a mariachi band. But there's a first for everything. And it's a wonderful pleasure and privilege to introduce my good friend, Randy Levine Miller.
Happy birthday, Meryl. Happy landmark birthday. You are one of the most beautiful human beings I've ever had the pleasure to know. And I remember when we first became friends, I used to say that you were like my fairy god sister, because I always felt that if I hung around Meryl, I was getting all this great fairy dust. And you are. You're a contagion of positive energy. And please God, the next 65 years will be very blessed. Now, when I think of Meryl, this is what I think of my friend Meryl. When the sky is a bright canary yellow, I forget every cloud I've ever seen. So they call me a cockeyed optimist, immature and incurably green. I have heard people rant and rave and bellow that we're done and we might as well be dead. But I'm only a cockeyed optimist, and I can't get it into my head. I hear the human race is falling on its face and hasn't very far to go. But every whippoorwill is telling me a bill and telling me it just ain't so. I could say life is just a bowl of jello and appear more intelligent than smart, but I'm stuck like a dope with this thing called hope, and I can't get it into my heart. Not this heart. You gotta have heart. All you really need is heart. When the odds are saying you'll never win, that's when the grin should start. She's got a full smile. You gotta have hope. Mustn't sit around and mope. Nothing's half as bad as it may appear. Wait till next year and hope. When your luck is batting zero, get the chin up off the floor. Oy vey. Mister, you can be a hero. You can open any door. There's nothing to it but to do it. You gotta have heart. Miles and miles and miles of heart. Oh, it's fine to be a genius, of course, but keep that old horse before the cart. First, you gotta have heart. And I know this is a very special birthday, and there's nobody like my friend Meryl. Nobody. One singular sensation, every little step you take. One thrilling combination, every move that you make. One smile and suddenly nobody else will do. You know you'll never be lonely with you know who. One moment in her presence and you can forget the rest. For this gal is second best to the incredible Doug Cohn.
Now I'm going to bring back the indispensable Steve Ross. One of the joys of participating tonight is to get the privilege of meeting wonderful and talented people. And I was asked to play the piano for this next guest. She is really a delight, and she was over in my apartment earlier today. She's so good with pets. She's really, I mean, my cat, and I'm never that demonstrative with my cat, but my cat was really happy today. And I actually kind of wanted to, like, give my cat to you because I think she'd be so much happier with you. And the dog would be, too. But I'm keeping the dog. But anyway, I digress. But I would like to bring to the stage Janet Aldrich. Yes. Well, she is singing a song that she sang in a show in the Nymph Festival, and she's going to tell you about it.
Hi, Meryl. Nice to meet you. This is a gift to you from Barbara Sickman and Ron. This is from Ben, Virginia, and me, the Liberace musical. And Barbara just wanted you to have this advice. At the Hotel Quisisana on the Isle of Capri, it was time for cappuccino, just my lovey dove and me. We walked by a store called Lena's. It said jeweler to the stars, with a window filled with diamonds laid on stacks of pure gold bars. I heard guitars and mandolins and gypsy violins. Jaime, won't you buy me the yellow canary diamond in the window? Jaime. Jaime, won't you buy me the yellow canary diamond that I see? Oh, that stone is mesmerizing. It's Zabar's appetizing. A hot pastrami from the Carnegie. It's my only guilty pleasure. Am I not the wife you treasure? It would symbolize the measure of your love for me, dear Jaime. He looked at me so quizzically, my little chickadee. He said, my darling, physically, you're sculpted perfectly. That stone's a mere distraction from the beauty that I see. So instantly, I knew I'd need a different strategy. It's time that we go straight for his ego and for his manly pride. Jaime, won't you buy me the yellow canary diamond in the window? Come on, I know you want to sing it. Jaime. Jaime, won't you buy me the yellow canary diamond that I see? With the purchase of that one ring, you can show the whole world one thing, that I'm married to a most successful man. Yes, it's all about impression. On Capri, there's no recession. It's the ultimate expression of prosperity. Bluebirds will sing the moment you get me that ring. Sparrows will fly, cockatiels sigh. What a guy. Falcons will flock the instant you get me that rock. Boy, what a catch. It's just chicken scratch when you see opportunity snatch. Dear Jaime, Jaime, won't you buy me the yellow canary diamond in the window? Jaime, Jaime, won't you buy me the yellow canary diamond that I see? I'll set your bed on fire. I'll fill you with desire. I'll satisfy your every carnal need. Oh, Jaime, refrain from telling me no, and you'll be my Valentino, and we'll celebrate in Reno with me on my knees. Oh, please, Jaime, for little old me. We're all birds of a feather. We chicks must stick together. So here's the lesson, old as time but true. You know it's true. There's a cardinal rule we all know, ladies. Listen up and follow. A canary diamond's always worth a swallow or two.
Yeah,
Barbara Sickman. I'm gonna bring the room down now. I have had such a great time working with Meryl. It feels like it's been a long time, but it really was. It was, yes, we are mishpacha now. And we had a lovely Sunday together going through the menu and of performers. And I thought what really, the song that really suited you, I write musicals, and thank you. Randy is a wonderful and valued supporter, and I wrote a show called No Way to Treat a Lady, and and there was a song in there that that was called One of the Beautiful People, and it's really, the title is so much Meryl. It really is. It's just, you are one of the beautiful people. And I wish I could sing that song for you. She really is. I'm not going to attempt that song. I'm not singing that song. Liz Calloway sang that song, and she did a great job. And I wouldn't want to desecrate that memory of those of you who remember her singing that song. But there is another song that I did write. And it's from a musical that I wrote with Douglas Carter Bean. And it's called The Big Time. And I think turning 65 is the big time, you know? So I'd like to sing that song for you. Don't know if there's a God. These days he likes to keep one guessing. But still I'll give a nod, saying thanks for every blessing. The rhapsody in blue, the scent of evergreens, the golden age of Burns and Allen's old routines. Thanks to ruby shoes and yellow submarines, and thank you for today. Thank you for the kicks from towering rockets. Thank you for the Met, and even for the Mets. Every bouncy note in Great Berlin duets. And thank you for today. Thank you for the strength to rise every time I fall. Thank you for the time at hand, the greatest prize of all. Thank you for the friends I met along the way. Though our time is brief, our love is here to stay. Every passing moment is a precious gift. I lift my voice and say thank you, whoever you are. Thank you for today. Okay, so I get confused between Adam and Todd. There's a resemblance between them, and I noted that earlier when Adam was here in the theater, and I said hello, and then I saw someone come out from here, and I assumed it was Todd. And I said, hey, you wanna go through the shadow waltz? And he looked at me like I had three heads. And he said, yeah, is that like an expression or something? Is that like a theater thing, you know? No, it's not. It's actually meant to be. He was very polite. It's meant to be for Todd. So here's Todd to come back, and hopefully he remembers the shadow waltz.
In the shadows, let me come and sing to you. Let me dream a song that I can bring to you. Hold me in your arms and let me cling to you. Let me linger long, let me live my song. In the winter, let me bring the spring to you. Let me know that I mean everything to you. Love's old song will be new. In the shadows when I come and sing to you. Shadows on the wall, I can see them all, here and there, everywhere. Silhouettes in blue, dancing in the dew. Here am I, where are you? In the winter, let me bring the spring to you. Let me show you everything I'd want for you. Love's old song will be new. In the shadows when I come and sing. In the shadows when I come and sing. In the shadows when I come and sing to you, dear. In the shadows when I come and sing to you.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Actually, Todd should probably stay up here, right? Yeah.
Okay. Hey guys, I'm back.
Yay!
Okay, sorry. Sorry about that. So,
hasn't this been a great show so far?
Hasn't this been wonderful? Hasn't every single performer, including the mariachis.
Yeah, yeah. I'm very happy to announce that we're almost at the halfway point.
Yes.
Almost.
Yes.
And sadly, I don't think I'm even kidding.
No. I think we've got some more, but we're
okay.
Almost.
Okay, good.
So anyway, one other thing that I think that we should know about our mom, you should know about our mom, is that she has a really great quality about her. She has an excellent memory for kind deeds. You know, she'll remember it. So, for instance, like I looked at the guest list here, so I know who you guys are. And I looked at the list, and I saw a name that looked unfamiliar to me. And so I asked my mom, I said, who is this person? And she said, I knew her years ago. She was kind to me. And so it was like, I said, I've never heard of her. When was she kind to you? And she said, before you were born. Yeah, and you know, I'm 35. I know it. I look like I'm 19, I know. But anyway, yeah. But I'm kidding, no. But so she, and by the way, this woman, I asked her about it. It's not like this woman saved her or, you know, found her a job. This woman probably waved at her.
Yeah.
And she remembered the kindness of the wave. she was kind to me.
That's very nice.
So that's really, yeah. So that's lovely about you. It's funny, I actually have inherited that. I also have an excellent memory for people who've done me wrong. You know?
Yeah.
No, I'm kidding. It's more like yours. Not quite as, you know, not quite as excellent. So anyway, so hopefully in, let's say, 30 years, no less than 30 years, mom will have dementia. you know, and she will go and visit her, and she won't remember her own name, of course, but she will remember that in 1978, you gave her a pin.
That's
you
nice.
Know, that pin, she'll always remember.
That's very
anyway,
nice. That's great. Yes,
you.
Let's get
so,
it up for
thank
Mom.
Thank you, Mom.
And to be sincere a little myself, you're seeing a theme, and it's true. You are, I've never met anyone like you in the sense of just trying to make people happy and cheer them up, and you've always taught us to, you know, brighten someone's day, make someone feel good, and that is always with me, and I'll always be
Thank
grateful
you.
To you for that. Thank you.
Echo. Oh,
what? What?
Am no. I okay?
Oh, you're
no,
fine.
No,
you're fine.
You're fine. No, we.
You're just
although,
65.
Yeah.
That's
although
it.
I will say that was very nice.
You.
Everyone was so good and funny, and Randy, I think, said that may you live another 65 years. If you live another 65 years, I'll be 100, and we will celebrate together. It'll be nice.
Yes.
Anyway,
a few more things.
Real, we got to go yeah, quickly. Yeah, yeah. You know, as twins, a lot of people ask us who's older. That's a very common question we get asked. And recently I've been telling people to guess. I say, hey, yeah. There's a 5-minute difference, okay? Why don't you take a guess? And recently most people have been guessing that Todd is older.
Yeah.
And the last person who did that, I said, I'm just curious, why did you guess that he's older? And they said, oh, because his hairline is further back than yours. See? Show everyone. Yeah. And at first I thought that was interesting logic. But then I thought about it, and I realized we're twins. So if you use that logic, that would mean that in 5 minutes, my hair will move from here to here.
Yeah.
So and that's we'll, why. We got 5 minutes.
Believe
okay?
me, we got
Let
5 minutes.
Let me know if you see anything.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay? And yeah, yeah. I'm older, okay?
Yeah.
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 Anyway, did you want to say something?
Anyway,
or do you want me to?
Yeah. So briefly, so... are you guys familiar with the phrase "in between jobs"?
Do you know that
you know,
phrase?
We like that phrase. You know, it means you're unemployed, but we like that a lot because it's very positive. You know, it's you know you may never find another job again, but more yeah. likely than not, you will.
Yeah.
So we think you can apply that to other areas of your life. So, for instance, if you're single, you could say, "I'm just in between girlfriends or boyfriends."
Yeah,
right.
Exactly.
Just in between. Or if you've been sad for a really long time, you could say, I'm just in between joyous times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So and now we're in between laughs.
Yeah, exactly.
But some
but
more
a few
pain.
Came back,
See?
So that's good.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah,
someone
yeah, yeah,
laughed
yeah.
up there. Thank
anyway,
you.
So speaking of jobs, I now work in a magazine by day, and I was at a party, and this guy asked me what I did, and I told him that I work in a magazine, and he said to me, he said, you know, magazines are going to die, so you should get out of that. So I said, well, you know, you're going to die, so should I back out of this conversation?
Yeah,
you
yeah.
know?
May as well
wait,
stop
wait,
talking.
Yeah, they're all
yeah,
going to die, we should just
yeah,
stop.
Exactly.
Right? So rude.
Exactly.
I remembered him.
That's
you know.
Good. Exactly.
Yeah.
There's a lot of rude people.
Yeah, absolutely.
I want to say something. You know, we don't really get into politics much, but we'll mention just this. We notice there's this one issue that isn't discussed much anymore, and that is capital punishment. Have you noticed, like, in all the politics that everyone talks about, no one really talks about capital punishment anymore, and it's a complex issue, and it's a little complicated, but we've talked about it, and there is one group of people that we do believe in capital punishment for, and that is certain types of children, okay? Now, hear me out. I know this sounds... I have two kids, and I was walking with my younger one. She's 2, and she's very nice. Her name is Orly, and I brought her to the playground, and we were walking, and then an older kid, maybe 3 or 4, she had a little pail, came up to her and yanked the pail out of her hands, and she said, huh? You know? And then the older kid said, shut up. You know, that's not nice. And I was thinking, like, that child should be executed. You know?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, come on. Like, what are you going to do? That's horrible. What's he going to be? He's going to be a punk.
A murderer.
When he grows up. He's a horrible person.
A terrible person.
Exactly.
You're preventing, you know,
I'm sorry.
Criminal activity.
Yeah, I think
yeah.
so. Some people like that. The other yeah. people are leaving. Anyway,
yeah.
Yeah. I'll juggle again. I'll do
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
by the
we'll
way, there were
the
so many great acts, musical
there
acts.
There were. Let's give a round of applause
again
for everyone. And for our piano players who've made us sound wonderful.
Yes, Yes.
Yeah.
None of them were juggling, though, so I win for the night.
Okay, so yeah, I think we'll
exactly.
move on.
So, yeah, let's move on. Let's or did we want to... There's a few more acts, or did, we're going to talk about
oh,
a few
okay,
more?
You want, okay, I don't want to... Okay, you want to hear... I'll brief. Keep it brief. So, I... So there's this new, there's a middle-aged homeless man who recently moved to the neighborhood, who I find quite attractive. Mm-hmm. And yeah. so he hangs around the neighborhood, and on my way to the subway, I see him just about every day. He hangs around on the floor, on the ground, which is kind of sexy, you know.
Yep.
So on the cement, whatever. And so he's on the ground, and on my way to the subway, almost every day, he says, can you buy me a muffin? Which is kind of hot, you know?
Yeah.
Can you buy me a muffin?
Yeah.
Can you buy me a muffin? Because I don't know, because I like muffins and I like him. It's like I'm rattled every morning. So yeah. anyway, so can you buy me a muffin? So like I never made eye contact with him. I've never gotten a muffin or anything. But I thought, well, maybe this is like a euphemism for something. I don't know. So I looked it up. Maybe it's a gay homeless thing. I don't know.
Yeah.
So I looked up on, can you buy me a muffin under the gay homeless euphemisms?
Yeah.
Apparently it's a thing.
Yeah.
So it came out that what that means is, can you buy me a muffin translates to just can you buy me a muffin?
Yeah.
It's the same
yeah.
thing. It was
Sadly,
really disappointing.
He was just hungry.
And I thought we were meant for each other.
Yeah,
you know?
Me too.
And we were in the neighborhood. It was
yeah,
easy.
I know. It's sad.
Anyway.
But you know, just thinking about mom has gotten me thinking about our ancestors and, you know, our great great grandparents, and they came over from Eastern Europe and they came by boat. They arrived in Fire Island. They were gay. And
his line was Fire Island.
Mine went to Ellis Island.
Yeah,
and then they met.
It was that kind of thing.
And the other thing I just want to share is, you know, mom was so close to her parents and Grandma Lydia, who many of you know.
Yes.
She was wonderful. And just one story I want to share with her. And that is, we were, I think, teenagers, and we were hanging around at our house, and she was there, and I was playing with a ball. It was just the three of us. And she said, you know, could you stop playing with that ball? And I said, why? And she said, because someone might fall and hurt themselves. And I said to her, I was like, of the three of us, who do you think that someone might be? It's just a nice, tender memory I wanted to share.
Nice, tender memory.
Yeah.
Nice.
Anyway.
Okay.
Moving along.
Yeah. We have the next person we have is Steve knows. And Doug, they always know.
Yep.
Sorry for the moment. Just kind of talk to... don't talk, please.
It's intermission. Is that what you're saying?
No, there's no intermission.
I'm kidding. There's no intermission.
No, don't go yet.
You will all be home by tomorrow, okay?
Yes, exactly.
It's fine.
Yes.
It's fine.
Okay.
It's fine.
Okay.
There are beds in the back.
Okay.
Could we welcome Arnie Zimmerman?
Oh, yes. Arnie. By the way, let me introduce Arnie. Arnie, by the way, that Arnie... is a really good friend. He's my mom's neighbor and he's my neighbor. In fact, all three of us are roommates. You know, I know I'm kidding, but we're not roommates. But we all live in the same building, and I consider Arnie a really really good friend. Please welcome Arnie Zimmerman. Come on.
Thank you.
Arnie Zimmerman. So, I'd like to introduce, and now for something completely different, Bill Dysack. Dysack? Dysel. It's misspelled. Sorry about that. Bill Dysel.
Oh, thank you. Yes, thank you very much. Yeah, Bill Dysel is my name. That other guy had to go get some breakfast. So we'll,
did you get a muffin?
He brought a muffin. Yeah. So the next part of the program is dedicated to celebrating Meryl's next birthday, because it's coming right up. So bear with us. But Meryl, I wanted to thank you for including me in Meryl's Medicare musicale. You know, you're entering a wonderful time in life, because this is the time you get to be a free spirit. You get to be a wise woman. And best of all, you get to be a hypochondriac. Bum 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 bum. Dr. Google, name my disease. Make it exotic and strange if you please. I hope it's rare, and if I'm in luck, it makes people think I'm gonna kick the bucket. Google, aren't you intrigued? I'm feeling dizzy and slightly fatigued. So order up an MRI. Dr. Google, figure out why. Bum 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 bum. Dr. Google, now I just sneezed. Is that okay or some new allergies? Does my condition require explanation or need a massive course of medication? Google, listen to me. I need emergency surgery. Fine, I'll do my own IVs. Dr. Google, operate, please. Bum, 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 bum. Dr. Google, can you be sure there's not some mystical miracle cure before you start transplanting my liver? Should I go swimming in the Ganges River? Google, I've had a spell, a psychic vision that I might be well. So thanks for all the things you give. Dr. Google, I just might live. Achoo!
Bill Dysel. So now we have a very, very special treat for you. I'd like to introduce a man who has many talents, doesn't juggle, but he does do two things practically at once, and that is Eric Hoffman. Eric Hoffman. Oh yes, here he comes. He's a coming.
He lives.
Yeah. Oh, you brought a shiny instrument.
All the things. Just gonna get dressed.
Thank you very much.
So all of this, I have to say, Stone and Stone, ladies and gentlemen. Are they hilarious? This whole thing makes me feel like a really, really crappy son. I could have done something like this, but I didn't. Man. Oh, well. So, for you, my dear. Never thought I'd fall, but now I hear love's call. I'm getting sentimental over you. Things you say and do just thrill me through and through. I'm getting
getting sentimental over you. I thought I was happy, I could live without love. Now I must admit, love is all I'm thinking of. Won't you please be kind and just make up your mind that you'll be sweet and gentle with me. I could live without love. Now I must admit, love is all I'm thinking of. Won't you please be kind and just make up your mind that you'll be sweet and gentle. Be gentle with me. Won't you please be kind? Because now I find that I'm getting sentimental over.
Thank you. Happy birthday, Eric.
Eric Hoffman.
Thank you, guys.
Todd is coming up.
Do we see Todd again?
Oh, me? Thank you. Wow. Thank you. I know you've had enough of me. Okay. Thanks. Okay, we're gonna start again here. Do you like it open or closed? It's not even supposed to be dirty. It's you like it open? Okay. Really? But I feel vulnerable. Okay, cool. Okay, sorry. Okay, let's begin. Yeah. We'll try one more certain time. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, one moment. I speak in another language when I get flustered. Okay.
When I first saw you, with your smile so tender, my heart was captured, my soul surrendered. I'd spend a lifetime waiting for the right time. Now that you're near, the time is here at last. It's now or never. Come hold me tight. Kiss me, my darling.
be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be too late. It's a now or never. My heart won't wait. Just like a willow, we would cry an ocean if we lost true love and sweet devotion. Your lips excite me, let your arms invite me, for who knows when we'll meet again this way. It's now or never. Come hold me tight, kiss me, my darling, and be mine tonight. Tomorrow will be too late. It's now or never. My heart won't wait. It's now or never.
My pleasure. Please welcome my dear friend for many years, the extraordinary writer and actor and comedian, Mr. Jim Brochu.
This is the one. The wait staff will be coming through in a few minutes to take your breakfast orders. Now, there we go. 50 years in the business and I can't work a microphone. There we are. Hello, everybody. Hi, my darling. I love you too, very much. She stalked me. That's with Magda. Yes, I know. This is a true story. Steve and I were having dinner with our dear, now gone friend Robert Osborne at Sardi's one night. And Magda and Meryl came up to the table, and I thought they wanted to talk to Bob, who wants to talk to me. And they said, no, you. Would you come over and say hello to our table? And I said, sure. It was the greatest piece of table hopping I have ever done in my life. Because having you in our lives, there are no words. No words. Now, this one here behind me, I've known for a few more than six or 7 years. I have known this man since 1970. When I was starting out as a young actor and Steve was starting out as a young pianist, he played my auditions for $5 an audition. Do you remember what my audition song was? I'll bet you're sorry now, Tokyo Rose. Sorry for what you've done. This is.
Did you get many jobs with that?
I got no jobs with that. But every Saturday night, Steve was playing at a place called The Painted Pony.
Right.
And I would go every Friday and Saturday night. And we had a tradition that at 2 o'clock on Saturday morning, when the bar was closing, we would close the evening with this, and Meryl asked us to do it for you tonight. So here we go, 40 years later. Stephen?
This is a good piece of advice for the two children who are not here. Go visit your grandmother. Go tell your granny that you care. Don't you know how glad she would be to look up and see you standing there? So go visit your grandmother as soon as you applaud the play. Give her due, sonny, you owe it to every granny in the USA.
go visit your grandmother, and you might even bring her flowers. Go and take her out for a walk. Maybe you'll talk for hours and hours. Go visit your grandmother as soon as you applaud the play. At the end of this play, call a cabbie and say, take me to Granny's tonight. Go. Don't be a louse like your brother Milty. He doesn't know the meaning of guilty. He likes to call her an alticaca. Someday he's gonna shock her off of a rocker. You just be nicer than he is. Go hand the little lady a laugh. You went to Fire Island this summer. For God's sake, show her the photographs.
One thing I'm going to tell you, this truth is plainer than day.
If it weren't for that little lady, where the hell would you be today? So give her due, Sonny. You owe it to every granny in the USA. Every granny in the USA. And that's one hell of a note. I have a surprise. Now, would you like to hear the reprise of Hello, Merrill?
Oh, my God.
Yes. Linda and I, we are one mind. So here is the reprise. An arpeggio of Hello. Hello, Merrill. Happy birthday, Merrill. We celebrate the day you came to be. Here comes Medicare and reduced bus fare and major discounts from the double ARP. I hope this don't bore you, 'cause we all adore you. We're so glad that you were born and you've got drive, thrive. Warm and clever, Merrill. More beautiful than ever, Merrill. Grab that knife for heaven's sake. Gather round and cut that cake. Here's to you and the next 65. Now wait. I have a big surprise for you. Merrill, I have a surprise for you, my darling. We've been going through something at our house. My darling partner of the last 33 years, Steve Shacklin, composer extraordinaire, broke his arm and had complete shoulder replacement, which is not good for a pianist. So just for tonight, he has been practicing and working through the pain.
Oh my God.
Because he wanted to play for you. So For the first time in 6 months, he's going to do it with one of his own songs. Stevie, come join us. Steve Shacklin, everybody.
I know this is a song that Merrill likes, and we both have gone through a lot. And you know, sometimes when you reach a really bad place, you have to reinvent yourself. As from the tomb stepped Lazarus, a man drawn back from death, I looked into the sunshine and I drew a ragged breath. In pain I had sought slumber, bone weary and alone, until at last you found me and rolled away the stone. Time to come out, time to come out. Lazarus, come out into the light, into the light, into the light of day. Time to come out, time to come out. Lazarus, come out, time to come out into the light of day. You made the sacrifice it took to reach me where I lay. You took the time to find me when you could have walked away. Now I'm no longer caught in anger, trapped within some game. You raised me from the ashes when you call me by my name. Everybody, time to come out, time to come out. Lazarus, come out into the light, into the light of day. Time to come out. Lazarus, come out. Time to come out into the light of day. I pray for all the children whose lives are cloaked in shame. And I pray for all whose hatred drives them to pointless blame. And I pray for greater courage to stand and face the crowd. I made a sacred promise to sing this love out loud. Time to come out, time to come out. Lazarus, come out into the light, into the light of day. Time to come out. Lazarus, come out. Time to come out into the light of day. Time to come out into the light of day. Thank you. Love you.
This has been a long and emotional evening. What a wonderful ride it has been. May we please welcome the lady for whom, who is the cause of our joy tonight. Meryl, come up and give us some one last thing.
To all of you. Well, my heavens, Adam and Todd. Oh gosh. My romance doesn't have to have a moon in the sky. My romance doesn't need a blue lagoon standing by. No month of May, no twinkling stars, no wide away, no soft, soft guitars. My romance doesn't need a castle rising in Spain, nor a dance to a constantly surprising refrain. Wide awake, I can make my most fantastic dreams come true. My romance doesn't need a thing but you.
Thank you.
Okay.
We didn't have time to do everything.
Here we go.
But
here we go. Okay, we got a thank you list here. Okay.
Here.
You
oh, yeah. Adam, come up.
I will.
Oh, good, good, good. Keep it up, Ed.
Over there.
I want you here. Okay. Hi, Vey. Well, excuse me. I'm just so happy everybody's here. Did everybody get their sandwiches? Did anyone get their sandwiches? And you know what? And I got to tell you, the wait staff is fabulous. Please tip them well. Because I know I'm a very nice and lovely woman, but I'm very confusing. And I've always been. So I am sorry that I have been so complicated with my wonderful sandwiches. But did anyone get them?
Yes.
You got them? Oh, good. We didn't get them. But thank you so much. Thank you. Okay. This is just going to take another hour. I really am so grateful.
I'm so grateful.
And I'm wearing my so many thank yous. That's what I wrote. So many thank yous. So many, many, many thank yous. Okay. Thank you to Peter Martin, the owner of the Triad. He's been great. Thank you. Gene Castle, you've been running everything, so thank you. And he runs the floor, and so beautifully, so wonderful. Shannon Epstein, thank you so much for sound and lights. John Fershman, yes, clap. Incredible video, I'm sure. And thank you so much. Zoe and Selena. Thank you. I repeat, the wait staff is wonderful. And you know, we must really, you know, give generously to these kids. They're wonderful. Okay. Oh, gosh, what did I do?
Here. Okay, keep going. I'll do it.
Okay.
I'll do this.
All of a sudden, it got tiny. I thought, whoa. Okay. Oh, gosh. Maestro. Steve Ross.
The two maestros.
I've got... And maestro, Doug Cohen. Yes. Wow, you know, am I a lucky gal? You know, am I lucky? Oh my gosh, this has been, I'm so grateful. And this is so important. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And to all of you. To all the performers, I gotta tell you, wasn't this the greatest show? Can you imagine? So what if it's midnight? Who cares? But thank you. And you know what? The mariachis, that was hysterical. That was supposed to be a surprise for everybody. But they were supposed to come at the end. And then, you know, and then evidently...
Sorry.
Because I love mariachis. And I love Mexico. And I have Mexican cousins. And I just, you know, I have cousins all over the world. But I love mariachis. And so the plan was it was going to be a big surprise for everybody. But they were coming at the end and then singing Happy Birthday to Me. You know, but what happened was that they were there, and they said
I was at complication. They came an hour early. They thought it was an hour earlier, and then they had a show in Staten Island. I'm not even kidding. It was, and they were upset that they were going to miss the show in Staten Island. So then we had them come in the middle.
Because
so
they had to leave.
Sorry about that.
Sorry, Walter and everyone and Jim, you're really terrific. Big, you know, great sports. Can you hold this,
yes,
please? That's why I can't see it. Okay, so, you know, to my buddies and really brilliant performances, Jim Brochu, Steve Chalchin, my gosh, I am so honored by that. You're the first one to do that. Jim, grandmother, my gosh, that was so beautiful. And Jim, your lyrics, and Sydney Meyer, who came in and out. Walter, that song makes me cry every time I hear it. You know, I actually did write. Walter, could you please play da 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 dee da 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 la da 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 do? And he knew which song it was. He knew which song it was. Okay. Sandy Durrell, Sandy, thank you so much. Linda Burns, brilliant, brilliant lyrics. Thank you so much. Randy Levine, you know, you were great. You were wonderful. Larry Weisfeld, bravo. Really wonderful on your lyrics. Yeah, both of you. No, I want you here,
but
too.
I need to get some.
Okay. Oh, Janet Aldridge, you are fabulous. And so you're going to go with that great show that Barbara's doing. So, and Barbara and Ron Sickman, and Ron is really a partner in everything. Larry Kirshner. So, Larry, you were great. And this was the surprise. And, the Janes. Were they fabulous? And they were just great, great. Thank you. And, forgive me, I thought everybody was sitting closer, but, this is great. And to Bill... Bill, and I loved what you wrote. That was just so wonderful. Thank you so much. And Eric Hoffman with his trombone. Woo-hoo! Oh, my. And Steve Weber. Steve, that was so fabulous. Thank you so much. And Arnie is my next door neighbor. I'm always saying, he really is, and he's so wonderful. Go, Arnie. And on the harmonica, and Arnie says, we both could have a bigger apartment if we go through the wall. And I just said, I can't lose the wall space. I have too many pictures. So so that's funny. And Stone and Stone, my lovies, Oh, the best.
Hold this.
Aren't they fabulous? They're fabulous. And they're coming up with a web series and that I'm very excited about. And it's called Going Both Ways. Going Both Ways. And fingers crossed, and it's gonna be great. And thank you to all of you. I'm looking at all your faces. I love you. I love you. Thank you.
Lovely.
Thank you. Where's Anne? Anne and Paul are over there. Thank you. And Anne Osnes. Thank you. And all the Shanes and Dutch and everyone. And I just, oh my gosh, this was just the most gorgeous evening. Zach, Kathy.
We'll end the evening with there you go. We'll have to do a little, oh my gosh, there it is. All right. Don't go away.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Anyway, we're about to having a little moment here.
You didn't see the back.
Okay. Let's go for the front.
For the front. This is not a fire hazard, I don't think. Just one'll do. Todd, don't burn your hand. It's good. Yeah, it's not worth it. Yeah. Now blow it. Yeah, there we go. And maybe, should I try it? Or no, it was hot. Let's just do it with one candle. Okay, ready?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear mom. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you all.
Thank you so much for coming. This doesn't work.
Thanks. It's been a long night, but a wonderful one.
Thank you so much. Glad
thank
you.
Todd really hosted everything for their mommy. Everything.
We have one more song that everybody's going to sing if you know it.
Yes.
I can't give you anything but love, baby. That's the only thing I plenty of. There you go,
baby.
Dream a while.
Oh, yeah, take it on the audience.
You're sure to find happiness, and I guess. Gee, I'd like to see you looking swell, baby.
Diamond ring.
only words doesn't sell, baby.
That lucky day, you know
darn well,
baby. Three times. I can't give you anything
but love.
Thank you.
Maestro, thank you.
Thank you everyone.